Thank you. I'm glad I'm glowing this morning again. You know how it is. It's early. All right, I put my
It was
glasses
yesterday.
on. Yes, this week I'm planning on being like Abraham and Sarah, and just making sure I eliminate every Lot and Hagar and Ishmael. You know what I'm saying? From my life, and just make the decisions that's going to be a blessing and not be sabotaging to my life. Yeah, so I'm excited about this week. Just sitting before the Lord and making good decisions, you know? So that's where I'm at this morning.
A fresh start, and we have to make up our mind. It's either you want to stay there and dead, or you want to go through that change.
Come on now.
It's
Yes.
precious hours.
Yeah, I want to change into the image of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
I want to be who God wants me to be, and I want to obtain what God says belongs to me. And so, as long as you keep Hagar around, as long as you keep Lot around, it blinds you from what God has for you, because that those are counterfeit blessings, and I don't want any counterfeit blessings, you know? I want what God has for me.
On the real thing.
Come on now.
Real thing
That's
or
not
nothing?
And when you get God's blessings, it doesn't cost you. You know what I'm saying? Like Abraham and Sarah, it cost them making the mistakes. It was painful, you know. And I don't want to pay unnecessary price and go through unnecessary warfare because of disobedience or leaning to your own understanding. And so sometimes you have to go back and say, you know what? I made a mistake. I didn't get it right, but now I am. And I'm going to be like Mary. And I'm gonna go at the feet of Jesus and stay there. Amen. I think Martha even changed too. Martha was running around doing all that stuff, and Martha got it right. You can tell Martha changed, Adonna, because when she went to Jesus that time with Lazarus, it was Martha who went. Mary stayed. And so I think Martha also had a whole epiphany. You know, where she's like, I'm gonna put God first. Because Jesus told her, Mary has chosen the better part and it will not be taken from her. And I think Martha changed because of that conversation. So we thank God for those one conversations that will change your life. Amen.
And I saw let us take some time, huh?
Yeah.
Just one, right? Not a whole set, just one word.
Just one word from the Lord.
One
You know,
word.
can change everything for real, for real. Like she got that one word. It might have felt hard, you know, when she first received it. Like, Martha, Martha, you're worried about too many things, honey. You're out of control, whatever Jesus said, right? And she listened. She could have been like, I don't know what he's talking about. No, you could tell that Martha listened, because when it came to John 11 now, when her brother died, and she was told the master is here, Jesus is here. She got up and ran to Jesus. And the other worshiper, Mary, stayed put. Mary was disappointed. Mary was caught up in her feelings. And so we saw that Martha did change. And that's all that God wants us to do, is to change. You know what I'm saying? Thank you, Joanne. Yes, Lord. That's all God wants you to do, is to change, to agree with him. And when you agree with him, that's where you're going to see your breakthrough. Abram had to agree with God. Sarah had to agree with God. And so we're going to have to come out of agreement with some things, because it's making you live beneath who God has called you to be. And so this week, I'm like, Lord, what is it that I need to come out of agreement with? Show me. I changed my mind. And that's the thing about it. Like, the enemy will tell you, oh, if you stop now, everybody gonna look at you and think that you're stupid and that you made it, pride. No, let me go ahead and humble myself and say it. I'm gonna acknowledge it, that I missed the mark, so that I can find the right spot and go back on the right track. Amen. What say you, Adonna? What's your response to that?
Go all the way with God, because trust me, is like I can tell you from from putting God first. Watch me, I am seeing honestly testimonies is coming. Testimonies is coming, and once you see we stand in agreement with God and with His word, Be obedient. Watch my obedience is greater than sacrifice.
Yes.
It watch my obedience would actually save your life.
Mm-hmm.
It saves you. It saves you from death. It saves you from the pain.
Yeah.
Obedience. Just make up your mind just to be obedient. And once you choose to be obedient, you see God first, you agree with his word. Watch my, you're missing nothing, you know. you're air missing. Take it from me. You're air missing nothing because I have seen on my life personally the joy, the peace, the anticipation, and I'm seeing where God is working things because I saw where certain prayers were lifted up last week. And good news last night, and then good news this morning.
Thank you.
Come on. Watch me. God said, when you say we really seek ye first and his kingdom.
Yes.
Watch me, all things. And the thing is, when we have God, we have everything.
Amen.
Because everything belongs to him.
Amen.
Everything belongs to him. So, yeah, I agree with everything you said this morning.
God is so good.
Everything, yeah.
That is so good. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Amen. Amen. And so we're just going to open up in prayer really quickly, and then we're going to continue on. I'm going to make sure that we continue to put God first, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all that we need will be added onto us. And it's not easy to let go of your Ishmael. It's not easy letting go of Lot, especially if you've been taking care of Lot for a long time. We already know Abraham already had a connection with Hagar and Ishmael, and it's hard to break away from the things that we've embraced for so long, them soul ties and things that you thought were you. And God is like, that was never you. And so it's good to get in the presence of the Lord so God can begin to perform surgery, because if you try to destroy the tares by yourself, you're going to destroy the wheat, because the tares and the wheat, they look alike after they grow up together. And so you're going to need for God to come in and to like get you know how he does it, his surgical equipment, and cut things off of you. Let God do it. Strip that stuff off. You're thinking, oh, this is me. No, that's not you. And God wants to reveal the real you to you, and you know who your spouse really is and your children and stuff like that. And so we have to go in his presence and let him do it. And so Heavenly Father, we thank you, Father God, for waking us up this morning. Father, we thank you for your love. We thank you for your kindness. We thank you for your mercy. Lord, we thank you for your grace. Father, we thank you for who you are. You are King of Kings, Lord of Lords. Father, you are the Alpha. You are the Omega. You are the beginning. You are the ending, Father God. Lord, we love you. We adore you. Father, you are everything to us, the air that we breathe. Father, you are our strength, our strong tower. You are our loving Father, God of grace. Father, we thank you for everything that you've done for us, for giving us life, health, and strength, for giving us this platform, Father God, giving us the body of Christ where we can come together. And you said wherever two or three are gathered in your name, touching and agreeing, Father, you said you're there. And that you will answer us before we even start to pray. And so, Lord, we thank you. Thank you for being omniscient, Father. Thank you for being omnipotent. Thank you for being omnipresent, Lord. And so, Father, we come boldly to your throne of grace this morning, all of us holding hands. Come into your throne of grace and mercy, Father God, to receive help in the time of need and to worship you in spirit and in truth, Father God. In the name of Jesus. Father, we come and we cast our cares on you. We're asking that you please forgive us of every sin, Father God. We're asking that you will cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Cleanse us with the redeeming, atoning blood of your son, Jesus. Whatever it is that needs to be washed away from us, from our spouses, from our children. Lord, we come as your watchmen and watchwomen, as your gatekeepers. And Father God, we stand in the gap for our families. Father, we're asking that you will forgive, be merciful, Father God, the same way you've been merciful to us. We're asking that you'll be merciful to those that we're praying for, Lord. that you would just cleanse them, dip them 7 times in the water of your word, Father God. I pray that they will be transformed. They don't even know how to get it right. The same way oftentimes, sometimes we don't even know. But Father, we lift them up this morning, Lord. Our children, our spouses, our relatives, our co-workers, business partners, Father God, our government. We lift them up to you this morning, asking that you would, Father God, intervene, that you will begin to reveal Christ to them like only you can, Father God, that you will wash away, Father, those things that's not of you, every sin, every wickedness, Father, wash them away with the blood of Jesus. We come to your throne of grace. Father God, grace is how we were saved. It was by grace that we were saved. And so, Lord, we thank you. Lord, I thank you and praise your holy name, Father God, that your goodness is upon us today. No matter what we have done, Father, you said to forget the former things. Yesterday is gone. Last week, gone. Last year is gone. And you told us to forget the former things because you're doing a new thing. And it's springing up, Father God, and we perceive it. And so we're letting go of the things that's not serving us. It's not a part of our purpose. We're letting go, Father God, of every Lot, Father God, every Ishmael, Father God, and any Hagar, anything that's not of you, Father God, we're letting it go. We're going up to the mountain, lifting up holy hands, Father God, in full surrender, putting on the whole armor of God today in the name of Jesus. And we are surrendering today. Father, we lift up our hands on the mountain of the Lord where we can become closer to you because of the blood of Jesus. And we lift up holy hands right now, Father God, as your angels are putting on the helmet of salvation upon us, Father, and every member of our households, because as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Father God, I thank you for your angels, your warrior angels, your ministering angels. They're here with us right now, putting the helmet of salvation on us, oh God, and buckling it up, Father God, in the name of Jesus, putting on the breastplate of righteousness around us, Father God, covering our hearts, covering our organs, Father God, protecting us from danger, seen and unseen, Father God. I thank you that you said guard our hearts, Lord, because out of our hearts flow the issues of life. And so they're putting on the breastplate of righteousness, Father God, and we have your will engraved, Father, engraved in the breastplate, Father, the same way the priests in the Old Testament had the stone of every tribe, Father God. We put on the burden of the Lord this morning. We put on the breastplate of righteousness, and we're going to continue to intercede for everybody, Father God, in the name of Jesus, because we have been called for such a time as this, Lord. And like your Esther, Father, we are your Esthers, oh God. We are your stars in the earth, Father God. Father, grace upon grace you've given to us, Father, to pray for other people. You've given us the strength to pray. Father God, grace is the ability, the strength you've given to us to do our assignments. And so you've called us to pray. You said men are to always pray. And so we put on the burden of the Lord right now. We put on the breastplate of righteousness, Abba. Father, we buckle up the belt of truth with the help of your angels, Father. We thank you for angelic assistance. We thank you for reinforcement, Father God. We thank you for your warrior angels. We thank you for your ministering angels, Abba, in the name of Jesus. We buckle up the belt of truth around our DNA today. We will no longer believe the lies of the flesh or the enemy. Father, we know the truth because your spirit of truth is on the inside of us, and he's revealing to us everything that we need to know and how to do it, what not to do, what not to say. Lord, I thank you that we are led by your spirit, Father God, and we will no longer make a mistake because we're not going in our flesh anymore. We're not trying to do our own thing anymore. We trust in the Lord with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength, and we lean not to our own understanding. In all of our ways, Abba, we acknowledge you and you will direct our paths. And so we buckle the belt of truth around our children, around their DNA. We buckle the belt of truth around our spouses. We buckle the belt of truth around our relatives. We buckle the belt of truth around our neighbors, co-workers, and business partners today, Father God. No more deception, no more strongholds. Father, I thank you that the scales are gone from our eyes, oh God. Ephphatha to our eyes, Ephphatha to our ears, Ephphatha to our hearts, oh God. You're beginning to show show us, show us, show us, oh God, the same way you show Abram, it's time to part ways with Lot. You can't go anymore in that attitude. You can't do that anymore. That's not serving you. That's sabotaging you. You're showing us the truth, Father God. What is the real issue? You're showing us the root of every problem and the solution. You're showing us the truth. You're revealing to us what's really going on in the marriage, what's really going on with the spouse, what's really going on with the fiance. That's real. What's really going on with our children? What's really going on in our bodies? So Father, you're revealing all things to us, Lord. You're beginning to enlighten us, Lord, in the name of Jesus. You're shining your light of truth upon us. Father, this is the week where you're giving us revelation and clarity. You're giving us the answers to what we've been asking you, and you're giving us the solution, Father God, because we are stripping away, casting our cares on you. Father God, you're pruning us. We're allowing you to prune us. Prune away all the lots. Father God, prune away the Hagars and the Ishmaels so that we can hear you, Father God. So we can hear you. That's why Moses went up the mountain, so that he would not be held down by those things. That's a distraction, Father God. The enemy bring those distractions. Our flesh bring the distraction so that we will not see your perfect will. But Father God, you're removing the distractions. Anything that's blocking us and our families from going all the way with you, anything that's blocking you, Father God, you're removing them now in the name of Jesus, because Lord, you're giving us this day our daily bread, Father God, and healing is the children's bread. You are healing us, Father God, from the lies that attack our lives, Father God, the decisions that we made that damage us. You are healing us right now, Father God, because healing is the children's bread, Father God. The belt of truth is around us, Father God, for you to show us and for you to heal us, and you are healing those places deep inside of us that nobody can see, because the word of God is alive and active. And it's sharper than a two-edged sword. And it goes deep down into your joints and marrow. Father God, we release your word to locate the prodigals, to locate those we're praying for. You are sending your word now. Sending your word now to heal them, Father God. Your word is truth. Your word is alive and active, oh God. You are saving the prodigals, Lord. You are healing our children. You are saving the whole household, oh God. Your word is traveling fast right now. It's fast. Father, you said you are hastening your word to perform your word. And so your word has been released, Father God, like the bullet from a gun, Father God, like a rocket. Your word is going now to meet, Father, those we've been praying for. Even us, your word is locating us, Father God, deeper than ever, Lord. And you are healing, oh God, healing our core, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father God, we hold up the shield of faith this morning. We will no longer be double-minded. Father, you said a person who's double-minded is unstable in all his ways. He's unstable in all his ways, and he will receive nothing. Father, we will no longer be double-minded. We will no longer be like the ocean, Father God, up and down. No, Father God, we're going to be constant. We're going to be constant, Father. We hold up the shield of faith this morning, and we trust in you, Abba, hallelujah. We trust in you with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength, Lord. We hold up the shield, oh God, and when we get tired, Lord, we thank you for the Aaron and the Ur, who's going to help us to hold up the shield of faith. That's what Moses was holding up. He was holding up the shield of faith, oh God. He was holding up his hands in prayer unto you. Father God, we look to the hills from whence cometh our help. Our help is coming from you. We hold up the shield of faith. We have nobody else, Father God. All we have is you, Lord. We hold up the sword of the Spirit, Father God. We chop up anything that's not of you, anything that's coming at us, wrong thinking, any wrong thoughts, Father God, any attitude that's not of you, any decision that's coming to us that's not of you, we chop him up, Father. Every adultery, we chop him up, Father. Any fornication, we chop him up. Every poverty, debt, and lack, infirmity, we chop them up, slice them down the middle. Every fear, every envious spirit, every jealousy, every witchcraft, we slice them down the middle. We bind the evil spirits and we cast them out into the abyss in the name of Jesus. We bind anything that's coming at us, oh God, that's not of you, Father. We are your watchmen. We are your prayer warriors. We are your battering ram, your battle axe, your weapon of war against the enemy. Today, Father. Father, you have woken us up this Monday to fight the good fight of faith. And so we pray, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And I decree and declare that we're in the secret place of the Most High God. And now you're releasing upon us all that we need, Father God. Father, you said no good thing will you withhold from us. You're releasing holiness upon our families. You're releasing righteousness upon our families. You're releasing humility upon our families. Father, you're releasing healing and restoration upon our families. Reconciliation, you're releasing it now, Father. Faith upon faith and grace upon grace, you're releasing more love. You're releasing the fruit of the Spirit upon our families right now. Father, you're releasing wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. You're releasing clarity upon our families. We're in the secret place of the Most High God, and you are, Father, giving us the downloads. You are filling our cups again, oh God. You are filling up our cups again where we were depleted and going through, Father God. Father, you're giving us water in the desert, water in the, Father God, you're giving us the water of revelation, the water of everything that we need, Father, is gushing out of the rock. You're giving us oil from the rocky situations. You're giving us honey from the rocky situations. You're giving it to us, Father God, water, oil, and honey coming out of the rocky situation, Father God. Right now, you're showing us how to extract the blessing. You're showing us, oh God, what to do, what not to do. You are guiding our steps, Father God. You're closing our mouths, Father God. You said be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. You're beginning to teach us again. We're in the classroom of the Most High God, and you're showing us the way to go, and we will no longer make a mistake. Father, I thank you, oh God. Those of us who've been down in the dirt, down in the cave, feeling broken, but can't tell nobody about it. God is meeting you in the cave. He's meeting you right there. You've been trying and trying, and you have not been able to get your breakthrough, but you're getting your breakthrough now. God is saying to you, get up, get up, get up, get up in the name of Jesus. I know they kicked you down. I know you kicked down yourself. I know you settled for less by bringing Lot with you and holding on to stuff you shouldn't have been holding on to. But I say, get up from your past. Get up and walk away from that thing. Get up from the ashes. Get up from the dirt. It's time to emerge from the cave. I'm doing a new thing for you. New thing for you. I've given you a new mind. I've given you a new spirit. I'm giving you new understanding. I'm giving it to you. Get up right now. Get up from that broken place. Get up from that place of pain and shame. Get up in the name of Jesus. By the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. You are no longer in the ashes. You are no longer in the dirt. I pray this over your whole family. It is your day of Pentecost. We are in the upper room. We are in the upper room with our hands lifted up, Lord. Your Holy Spirit is coming upon everybody in the household. Lord, I thank you that you're saving the whole household. Nobody will be the same again. They're getting the revelation of who Jesus Christ is. Oh, they're surrendering now, oh God. They're surrendering now, oh God. Oh God, they're surrendering. Do you want to be made well? Do you want to be made whole? God is healing you right now. Father God, put that desire in our spouses. Put that desire in the people we're praying for, that they want to be well. Abraham realized he wanted to be well. Sarah realized she wanted to be well. And Father, when she made that decision, you began to open up her womb, Father, and you gave her her own promise, her own baby, Father. We, Father, want to be made well. We want to be delivered today, Father God. Anything that's distorting our vision of you, anything that's causing us not to hear you properly, remove them now, Father God, in the name of Jesus. We are fully sold out this morning. Father, we're casting everything on you, Lord. We cast them now, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We surrender, surrender, surrender. Father, we've come to a place now. All we have is you and we want nothing more. Father God, begin to transform our lives. Take our emptiness and give us the water of your word and convert your water, transform it into wine right now. We're asking for a Monday of miracles. This is a Monday where you're doing the miracle signs and wonders, where you're shifting things, shifting things, shifting things. Things are changing, changing, changing. I decree and I declare it. When Paul and Silas began to pray and praise, the shackles came off the people. Father God, the prison doors open up as we are praying today on one accord. Our prodigals, even us who have been trapped in prisons, the satanic prisons are pulverized. place right now with the anointing, the blood, and the word. And the captives are set free because the spirit of the Lord, the spirit of the sovereign Lord God is upon me to set the captives free, to speak healing to you. I speak healing to your body. I speak healing to your spirit. I speak healing to your soul. The anointing right now has been released upon you. Your body is being repaired. Your soul, your mind, your will, and emotions are being repaired right now. Your spirit is being repaired right now. God is repairing you in the name of Jesus. You're no longer poor. Those of you who've been poor in your faith, poor in your spirit, poor in your attitude, poor, poor, poor. God said, you're not poor. I made you wealthy, wealthy. My son became poor so that you can be rich, 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 rich. The blessings of Abraham belong to you. You are wealthy in your faith. You are wealthy in your strength. You are wealthy in your prayer life. I'm providing for you all that you need. Continue to seek first the kingdom of righteousness. Continue to seek my kingdom and my righteousness, and all that you need will be added unto you. No good thing will I withhold from you. Oh, I'm giving you everything that you need. I'm making a way for you out of nowhere. Continue to press in, press in, press in, and don't you stop. Don't you give up. Don't you give up. Don't you give up. Keep on pushing, 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 pushing. Keep on pushing, pushing, pushing. Yeah, you're making progress, progress, progress. I see the prison doors open, 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 open. And the captives are running out, running out, running out. Because the Son of Righteousness is shining upon you with healing in its wings, in its wings. God is healing our families. No longer bound, we're leaping from the stall. Leaping, leaping, leaping into a new beginning. That's why God said, forget the past, forget the past. I'm doing something new in your marriage, with your spouse, in your children. I'm doing something new. Don't let the enemy take you back. Don't look back and turn into a pillar of salt. You will not be like Lot's wife anymore, stuck in the past. The past is over, over, over. Behold, I do a new thing, new thing, new thing for you. It's springing up right now. Don't you perceive it? I'm making a way for you. I have already made the way for you. Stop looking back. Stop looking back. You're not the same person anymore. If any man be in Christ, he's a brand new creation. All things are passed away. Behold, everything is new. You are brand new. Your mind is new. Your heart is new. Your spirit is new. Your marriage is new. Your spouse is new. Your children, new, 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 new. New mercies I've given to you. New grace and favor. New joy, new strength, new peace. Oh, new forgiveness, endurance. New endurance, new strength, new strength, new strength. In the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I praise your holy name. And now we have the mind of Christ. We have wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. We're making godly decisions, and we're being catapulted into where we should have been 5 years ago. I speak divine acceleration upon us. Oh, divine acceleration, because when you mess around with Lot, Hagar, and Ishmael, it causes you to be stuck. When you keep on looking in the past, like Lot's wife, you're stuck, but you're stuck no more, no longer in quicksand, no longer planted and rooted in the past. No, no, no. God is uprooting you, and God is catapulting you to where you should have been 5 years ago. God is giving us divine acceleration, divine healing, accelerated healing, accelerated healing, accelerated healing. You should have been healed. The enemy tried to block your healing. He's trying to block your healing. It's blocked no more. 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 It's so we strike the rock this morning, and healing is coming out, coming out, coming out, gushing out right now. Healing is your portion, your portion, your portion. Receive it now in your body, your body, your body, your body. Be healed by the stripes of Jesus. Whatever the infirmity is, whatever that's been plaguing your body, I speak the word right now. By the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. And God's word is sharpening a two-edged sword. It's going to that place right now to perform surgery, because you shall recover it all. And you're in the recovery room right now, recovering all your blessing, recovering in your body, recovering in your mind, in your soul. Those of you who are suicidal, I take authority over the strong men of death and suicide and depression and oppression. I bind and cast them out into the abyss. You have the mind of Christ. You're no longer depressed or oppressed. You have the joy of the Lord. God's joy is filling you up. God's love and mercy, grace, and truth is overflowing in you. You will no longer be depressed and suicidal. God has renewed your mind and healed you, healed your soul. Your soul is restored right now in the name of Jesus. Those of you who are going through poverty, you can't pay this, you can't pay that. God said, I will meet all of your needs. Right now, right now, now, right now, right now. No good thing will I withhold from you. I will make a way for you out of nowhere. Go to the water, and the first fish that come up, open its mouth, and the money is in the mouth of the fish. God is giving you miracles, signs, and wonders. Your blessing will come supernaturally because you serve a supernatural God, and you're not normal. You are a royal priest of the holy nation. You're God's child, and he's called you up out of darkness into his marvelous light, and he's gonna bless you supernaturally. Your money is coming supernaturally. God gonna bless your business supernaturally. He's doing it. God is giving you favor the same way the stars in the sky, you can't count them. That's how much favor God is getting ready to cause to explore beautifully in your life. Favor is your portion in the name of Jesus. God is meeting that need for you. No good thing would he withhold from you. When Lot was removed, God showed Abraham everything. He said, all this I will give to you. And because you've been obedient to God, when you seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, all that you need will be added unto you. If you be willing and obedient, you will eat the best of the land in the name of Jesus. And so I bind disobedience, cast them out into the abyss, and I release obedience upon our children. They shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be their peace. I release obedience upon your spouse. I bind that vagabond spirit. I bind that orphan spirit. I bind that wayward spirit, that prodigal son spirit. I bind it. Cast them out into the abyss. That pride, that witchcraft, I bind and cast them out into the abyss. And I set the prodigals free. And he whom the Son has set free is free indeed. This is their day of breakthrough. They are born again. They are born again. They are born again, emerging into their godly purposes and their godly identity for the glory of God, for the glory of God. God has poured out his spirit upon everybody, and our whole household, sons, daughters, old men, young men, old women, maids, everybody is speaking in tongues. God has poured out his spirit upon us. We are prophesying. We are serving the King of Kings on one accord, walking around the Jericho walls together, shouting the word of God together, and watching the walls tumble down together. And we advance and we go forth to establish the kingdom of God in the name of Jesus. I seal this prayer with the blood. And all of us, who I seal us with the blood and the seal of the Holy Ghost, and there will be no backlash or retaliation of the enemy. Oh, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I praise your holy name. I cover this broadcast. I cover all of us with the blood. Every family, I cover you with the blood. I cover this teaching that we're getting ready to get with the blood of Jesus. Lord, I thank you that we're not going to leave here the same way we came. Father God, I thank you that you just washed us. I thank you for your glory that's upon all of us. We're going to see the weight and feel the weight of your glory in our houses and wherever we go today. You are protecting us and you're blessing us, Lord. In the name of Jesus, the whole household is transformed. The whole household is serving the Lord, serving the Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I praise your holy name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Now we're ready to go into our lesson. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I praise your holy name. I am ready to hear what thus saith the Lord. In the name of Jesus, glory to God. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we praise your holy name. We're armored up and we are ready to go. We are ready to go. Father God, we've been praying and fasting on Wednesdays. And Father, I thank you that you've already healed our marriages. Our marriages are sweeter than honey. Holy, anointed, on fire. We speak it. Death and life are in the power of our tongue. Father God, you said you would do it for us. And so we thank you, oh God, that we are planted by the river of living water, Father God, the rivers of living water, Father God. And I thank you that you said, blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose trust is the Lord. He is like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream and does not fear when heat comes, for its leaves remain green and is not anxious in the year of drought, for it does not cease to bear fruit. And so we stand on Jeremiah 17:7-8 all day today on repeat. We are blessed. Why? Because we trust in the Lord. God is our whole trust. God is our whole trust, and we are planted by the water. We're in the water of the word, the Ezekiel 47 river, and wherever the river is flowing, there's life. And so we decree and declare that that river is flowing upon our families, and we live life and life more abundantly, and out of our bellies are flowing rivers of living waters, period. Our children, they're living for God. Our spouses, they have new lives. They're serving the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Amen. We don't fear anything. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love, power, and a sound mind. You will not fear when heat comes, when the attacks come against you, and the enemy is trying to fight you. Listen, God is fighting your battle. Stand still and watch God fight for you. You on repeat, your leaves will remain green because you are meditating upon the word of God day and night. And you don't have to be anxious, because God said, be anxious for nothing. Pray, pray, pray. And God is going to move on our behalf. And so there's no more drought. The drought is over in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. And Lord, we thank you for day 524, Monday, January 24th, 2022. In the name of Jesus, Father God, I thank you that we are armored up. No more strongholds, because we have the truth. The belt of truth buckled around our DNA, Father. We know this is spiritual warfare, and you fight the battles for us, so we don't have to act crazy fighting for ourselves. No. And we trust you, Father God, and we're going to continue to worship you in spirit and in truth today in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. We trust you. This morning, the Holy Spirit said, go get this song. I had a different song, and now I see why he said put that song on. Because it's time to go back to that place of trust. Let me go back there. Because sometimes when you're going through so much, you say you trust God, but you sometimes just start going through cliches. Okay, I trust God. Okay. No, that place of trust, for real, for real. Where you're like, I know my God is coming. And you believe that thing all the way in your marrow. God has to be your trust. God has to be your trust. And I know that I'm speaking to those who know this already, but you need to hear it again, because faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord. You're blessed. Blessed means to be happy and fortunate. Whose trust is the Lord. That means you're blessed. And you are not uprooted and blown in the wind. You are rooted and grounded in the love of God. And so is your children. So are your children. So is your spouse. We are rooted and grounded in the love of God. And our roots are going through and getting the water of the word. And we're not worried about anything COVID and whatever else that's going on around the world, because we're staying in the Lord. Psalm 91 is our portion. Amen. And so we're going to continue to trust Abba. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you, Lord. We praise your holy name. Will you keep on trusting the Lord, or will you trust your problems? No, I trust God. I don't trust in my problems. I changed my mind. I'm not trusting in Lot, Hagar, or Ishmael. I'm trusting in the Lord and in his word. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Trust me.
In the name of Jesus.
What if you call me and don't feel me near you, but you still trust? What if I tell you to let go? The very thing that you think you have to hold. Will you trust me? Yes. I'll trust you, Lord. What if it costs my life? Yes. I'll trust you, Lord. What if I lose the very thing I love so dear? Yes. Somebody say, yes, I'll trust you, Lord. Somebody say, yes. Come on, put your hands up and say, yes, I'll trust you. I'll trust you. I'll trust you.